Hello, Meeple. So this is a new podcast that I'm starting for another story that's not scripted. I have it all written out on my community page, but I didn't think that would get much attention on its own. So here we go. This story is called "Alone in Death Valley," and So all the adults are voiced by my mother, who is in her pajamas, so she is off screen. She is the arm that was, like, doing this to me near the beginning of this video. let's get started. The part to your top right, that's the story. And, yeah, I will be reading that to you and my mother. Okay. Alone in Death Valley, Chapter 1. Death Valley, not the most welcoming name, huh? That's what I thought, and yet there are still 1.1 million visitors per year. I ponder why so many people would want to visit Death Valley as I stare at the hottest place on Earth outside the car window. Of course, my family wasn't there as tourists. Death Valley was simply the fastest way to get to our new home in Nevada. My family consists of Mom, Dad, and my little sister. Dang it.
That's correct. And my little sister.
And my little sister, Vicenta, and me, Aylin Ream. Okay, sorry. I just noticed a mistake that I cannot edit. Okay, my family consists of Mom, Dad, my little sister, Vicenta, and me, Aylin Ream. Our life on the coast of California was pretty much perfect, except for the small size of our home. Personally, I don't mind living in small spaces. I prefer it, in fact. But my parents decided that was not enough space for us. It was the last straw when my mom got pregnant. We were moving, and that was final. The problem was our family was poor, and there wasn't a bigger house that was affordable for miles. The only one we could find was in Nevada, which meant there was no chance we could keep any part of our old life. But that didn't stop my parents from buying it. Now we were on our way to. We were on the way to our new home, and I was wondering how our new life could be worth it. I liked my life, and I liked my life the way it was. At least I would still get to keep my pen pal, Kenzo. Kenzo actually has an interesting story. Both his parents are glaciologists, so he's lived in Antarctica his whole life. The only reason I know him is because he was doing prank calls one day and typed my mom's number. Mom assumed he was from school and handed the phone to me. From there, we just kind of became friends. Fate can really work in mysterious ways sometimes. I look to my right. Vicenta is asleep. Now is my chance to talk about serious topics with Mom and Dad. Are you sure we have to move? I ask.
Now, Aylin, we've been over this. Dad replies annoyed.
But is a bigger home really worth abandoning our way of life?
You know, there was no way we could have fit three growing children into a home with only one bedroom.
We'd find a way.
That is no life for a newborn baby.
Dad angrily yells. Dad's voice startles Vicenta awake, and she starts crying. Mom begins panicking.
San Jin, pull over. I need to comfort Vicenta.
She told Dad.
All right, Esmeralda.
The car stops, and Mom rushes into the back seat. I don't do anything but sit there with my arms crossed. We aren't even at the new house yet, and our life is already falling apart. If you want to read that, and that's all on my community page. I have to start my bedtime routine, so I have to go. I will be, throughout the course of the next year, maybe two, I don't know, I will be uploading the chapters on my community page and then making videos to read it. Sorry about the typos. I'll fix that someday, but I can't edit my old community post, so I have to, like, repost it with just that. That's kind of all. Mother, would you like to say goodbye to them?
Goodbye.
Okay. Bye.